culmination of the creation of man is his image and his ability to think and talk, okay? That is the completion of the glory of God. Because if man was just image alone and could not speak or express or create, then he would not be like God. But he is like God in his image and in him becoming a living soul. That is the fullness of God expressed in man, okay? So the prophetic actually, this is powerful because the prophetic goes back beyond creation. The prophetic is before creation, okay? It speaks before creation because it speaks to creation, and then it speaks to what creation must accomplish. So it speaks to creation to create man. It speaks to the purpose of man as he is created. It's powerful, powerful. I won't get too heavy into it, but we can really work with that just alone, okay? So in Ezekiel, in verse 17, in chapter 13, he's called to stand against. He is not called to speak first. He is called to be a presence. He is called to be a presence. And I know you hear me say it often, even in church, do not undervalue your presence here, because your presence speaks prophetically. Your presence speaks prophetically. This is why you are indwelled with the Holy Ghost. That spirit is a presence in your life.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
If God, this is powerful to me, because if God never spoke another word to you, his presence is powerful enough to deliver you without him speaking ever again to you.
Amen.
Powerful.
Amen.
Because his spirit dwells in you.
Amen.
So he never has to speak another word to you,
Amen.
And his presence, Amen. His glory,
yes.
is enough. It's
yes.
create. Yes. The Bible says creation.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. is speaking and
yes.
trying to reveal the glory of God.
Mm-hmm.
And creation can't even talk.
Mm.
Creation has no voice.
Mm.
See, not an audible voice at least, but creation does speak in its reference to its presence.
Yes.
And this is why it's waiting what? Creation is waiting for what? The manifestation of what? The sons of God. It's not looking for somebody just to speak. It's looking for a presence.
Yes. Yes.
Creation is looking for a presence.
Yes. Amen.
To even go further, I'm trying to get off of this, but to even go further, when Christ died, the sun and the moon began to go black.
Yes.
His presence, because
yes.
a presence.
Yes.
was about to leave the earth.
Yes.
And that in that presence, at least for that time, was creating a darkness on the earth because of presence.
Yes.
It wasn't because of what he said. It was because of who he was and where he was and that presence.
Amen.
And then he said, Father, I commit my spirit unto thee.
Yes.
Boom, immediately the earth now travails because the Son of God, his presence.
Yes.
Powerful.
It is.
Powerful.
Amen.
So I want you to understand when Ezekiel must stand against, it is a prophetic presence.
Yes.
Made manifest in Jerusalem.
Mm.
This is even more powerful because in chapter 3, verse 14, is somewhere between verse 12 and 14. He said, I went to those who were captive at the edge of Tel Aviv and sat with them
yes.
in bitterness of spirit.
Yes.
In the heat of my spirit, I went. He went to give a word.
Yes.
But because of the bitterness of his spirit, he was compelled to go, but his spirit was bitter. And because of his spirit being bitter, he could not even speak.
Mm.
He had to sit with them. The Bible says he was constrained
yes.
in his
yes.
spirit
Amen.
To sit
Amen.
And be the prophetic presence before you even speak a word. So the same thing that is happening in chapter 3 of Ezekiel transitions to chapter 13, verse 17. as you sat with the people who were in exile, the exiles who came back to the border. So exiles come back to the border, but they didn't have rights to rebuild the city, and they were living on the edges or the outskirts of Jerusalem. Some live even somewhere close into the city limits, but you know how it is. You live in the outskirts, and you might live in Shaker, but it's, it says Cleveland, and you don't know if it's Cleveland or Shaker, and the kids go to different school districts depending on what side of the street. That's how the exiles were in chapter 3 when Ezekiel sat with them. They were on the fringes, on the edges of the city. He had to stand against. So we have to be clear through prophetic. I want us to be solid and mature in this. Is a presence. It's not just a voice. It is a presence. This is why when they went to arrest Jesus, they fell back.
Yes.
He didn't even say a word. But when they came upon him, the prophetic presence.
Yes.
I want you to understand. I want you to understand that we carry this. Amen. It's not our words.
Amen.
It's our presence first.
Amen.
And after we sit in it,
amen.
Then we can speak in it.
Yes. Mm. Amen.
Yes. Amen. When we sit in it,
yes.
We can speak in it.
Amen.
But not until we sit in it.
Mm. Amen.
And too many people are trying to speak the prophetic instead of sitting in the prophetic.
Amen.
Because when you sit in the, when you really sit in the prophetic, you don't have to speak. It speaks for itself.
Amen.
I wish that we had manifestations from nonverbal moves of God.
Jesus.
Wow.
We need music and words and mouths and all of that, but there is a prophetic wind that is trying to come in.
Yes.
That's not trying to speak.
Yes, it is.
It's trying to stand against something.
Amen.
Without words.
Amen.
No words.
Amen.
The very fact that I touch you, or the very fact that I'm in your presence,
yes.
That you
yes.
know that the glory of God is in this place.
Yes. Mm. Amen.
Oh my God. Amen. If believers knew that, we would be constrained like Ezekiel in our spirit, and we would be able to stand against the enemy.
Amen.
Knowing that the enemy is not the people that we're looking at, it is a spirit that is not speaking to them.
Amen.
But causing like a puppet master strings to be pulled and things to happen with no verbal communication.
Yes.
The enemy is not speaking to people and telling them to do stuff. He's pulling strings.
Yes.
Not verbally.
Yes.
No communication.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus said you lie because your father is of the devil.
Yeah.
He didn't say the devil told you to lie. He says where you come from, you're already going to do it because he's already pulled your strings. Nonverbal. You see, nonverbal. I want to get this locked into our spirit. The prophetic is not just voice.
Yes.
It's presence.
Yes.
And Ezekiel speaks powerfully to this presence. Son of man, stand against.
Wow.
Don't speak against.
Amen.
That blocks the enemy.
Yes.
Let there be a presence there. Oh, she ain't told her this shit. Listen, this is so powerful that even burglars and people who look for victims, when there's a presence of a male,
Jesus.
That's next house.
That's true.
A presence. This just a presence. Just the man doesn't even have to live there.
Nope.
If they see him there frequently.
Yes.
No, I won't take that chance. Yeah. I don't want to take that chance for somebody to what? Stand against me.
Mm.
Presence. Presence. when we unlock this mystery, we would speak far less and let the prophetic flow out of us like an aroma.
Amen.
And God was telling me, he said, son, I want the prophetic to fall out of you like an aroma.
Amen.
Fragrance.
I just wanted to.
It's good.
I just want them to know. I just want somebody to know your presence was there.
Mm.
If you never said another word, I just want them to know your presence. Powerful. So let's make sure we're clear before I just step off into this next part, because it's essential that prophetic is presence, the invoice, not the other way around. Yes.
I just want to say this, not trying to give kudos to my sisters or anything like that, but the fact of the matter is, I know when they're not here.
Mm-hmm.
I know when they're not here.
Yes.
There's a lack of that presence.
Yes, yes, yes. It should be. That, but that's an indication of the prophetic too.
Yes.
When it's removed.
Yes, yes.
They knew the glory of God had been removed. And when Eli found out that mm-hmm. the ark of the covenant was gone, he fell back. Right. Broke his neck because the glory of God had right. left. They knew. Right. They knew. Right. They knew. And it's scary. It's scary because we live in a generation with too much voice, too yes. much entertainment, too yes. much music, and not enough presence.
Wow.
So we don't know when the glory departs because we haven't sat in it.
Mm. Wow.
We wouldn't know if the glory was gone or not because there's so much around us that's saying this is it. But that's not it. It's presence first. And as Ezekiel is sitting and listening to the false prophets, as he's standing in the place, you have to understand now, Ezekiel has barged into these places. He's not welcome. I wish I wanted to talk to you now. When he tells him to stand against, he's not welcome.
Right.
They don't want this prophet in there. They don't want this prophet in their business, just standing there. They know what he represents. They know what his spirit represents. Yes. They don't want this prophet up in here. You know, but he is called to stand against, and if they put him out, then stand outside. Because your presence is not a location.
Yes.
It's not a location.
Okay.
So if he went into these places and they put him out, then stand close enough. But I want you to stand against it. Presence, 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 presence. Mm-hmm. You should know when people aren't here, when they carry a prophetic presence.
Mm-hmm.
It should be a void. Mm-hmm. It should be. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It should be. When that presence leaves, then you should know it.
Right.
It's like a window open. You know
right.
it's open.
Right.
You don't know where the draft is coming from. You don't quite know. You have to research it and do all of that. And you can't, you know, and if you're tired, you're just going to get under covers or get another cover. You don't want to get up at night. But
yeah.
you know it's a wind in there.
Yeah.
You know, oh, there's a draft in here. Is it a window open? What happened? Is the door open? In fact, the other night, the police came to my house. My door was cracked open. And I didn't even know it. And my son woke up and didn't even recognize that they were there. He opened the door and all of that, but something changed, and I didn't even recognize it changed. And that's what I'm saying about the prophetic, that if you don't sit in it, you won't know it when it changes. You won't know when God is trying to shift and change things because we're so busy speaking and listening to noise that we don't sit in the prophetic to let it soak into us.
Mm-hmm.
A prophetic soaking. It's called meditation. We haven't done it. We haven't done it well. We have not done it well.
No, help, oh God.
We have not meditated well.
Yes.
True.
We prayed well, but we have not meditated
true.
Well. It's, remember, I said it's not words, so it's not even prayer I'm
right.
talking about tonight.
Right.
It's just a soaking in a presence.
Yes, yes.
That God, if you don't speak to me, you've already spoken just by your presence.
Jesus.
Yes. Ooh, I love it. I love it. I love it. Stand against, son of man. Stand against them.
Wow.
Don't speak. Stand against presence. So Ezekiel is not only soaking in, I want you to understand now, when you have a prophetic presence, you must understand that you're not just like floating, you know, not that. You're zoning in. To the atmosphere.
Mm.
See, I want you to hear what they're telling these people.
Mm.
I want you to watch their body language and what they say. I want you to watch how people respond to them and how people's reactions are to their words. I want you to see all of this. So he's not caught up in a trance now. That happened in chapter 3.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
When he stands against, he's not in a trance. He is keenly focused on what is happening around him. And his presence represents the block or the guard or the